Hi guys, welcome to my YouTube channel. This video will walk you through how to create custom layers with the Keras subclassing API. Here's what you'll learn in this tutorial. First, we'll briefly discuss what Keras is. Next, we'll cover ways to create layers in Keras. After that, we'll take a look at what the Keras subclassing API is. Lastly, we'll explore how to create a custom layer with the Keras subclassing API, step by step. Okay, we saw the topics we'll handle. Let's start with what Keras is. When it comes to implementing deep neural networks, you can use two popular open source frameworks, TensorFlow and PyTorch. Keras is a deep learning library in TensorFlow. One of the main features of Keras is its easy-to-use API, which allows users to quickly define and train deep neural networks with just a few lines of code. There are three methods to build a model with Keras. These are the sequential API, the functional API, and the subclassing API. The easiest of these is the sequential API. With this API, you can easily build simple deep learning models. But because it's not flexible, it's difficult to construct complex models with this method. It's a good idea to use the functional API to build multi-input and multi-output models. This method is both simple and flexible. Both the sequential API and the functional API are declarative. In other words, you create the architecture of the model by declaring the layers and how these layers will be connected. You then feed this model with data. By doing this, you can easily save, copy, and share your model. In the declarative approach, it is also quite simple to debug, as the entire model consists of fixed layer graphics. However, the declarative approach is not suitable for constructing dynamic models. For example, some models may include loops, conditional branches, and some other dynamic approaches. In such cases, it is better to use the subclassing API. Subclassing API is generally used for academic research because it's more dynamic than other approaches. In summary, the sequential API is the easiest to use and best suited for simple models. The functional API is more flexible and best suited for complex models. And the subclassing API is the most flexible and powerful but requires more coding effort. Cool, we have briefly discussed the pros and cons of the three API we can use to build models in Keras. In our previous videos, we talked about how to use the sequential API and the functional API. You can find the link to these videos in the description box below. In this video, we'll focus on the subclassing API. With the subclassing API, you can create both custom layers and custom models. Let's move on to creating custom layers with the subclassing API. To create a custom layer with the subclassing API, you define a new class that inherits from the tf.keras.layers layer class. When defining a layer, you can use three methods: init, build, and call. Let's say you want to create a dense layer. You define instance attributes in the init method. In the build method, you create the weights. Lastly, you perform the forward computation in the call method. Let's take a look at these methods. First, let's import TensorFlow and Keras. Import TensorFlow as TF. After that, let's import Keras. From TensorFlow, import Keras. Good, our libraries are ready for analysis. Let's go ahead and create a class named Linear. Let's write class Linear. Let me inherit this class from Keras.layers layer class. Let's pass Keras.layers layer class. Now, let's create the init function. Note that the init method will run when we get an instance from the class. Let's write def init. Keep in mind that the first parameter of this method is always the self keyword. Let's set self. Now, let's pass a units parameter and give it to, let's say, 32. Let's move on to using the super keyword. With the super keyword, we can both use the attributes and methods of the linear class and change any of them we want. Cool, we set the super keyword. Let's go ahead and create an instance attribute named units. To do this, we're going to use the self keyword. Let's write self units equals units. Cool, we created the first instance attribute. Next, let's create our weights. TensorFlow encourages us to create layer weights inside the build method. When the call method, we're going to create a little later, is executed, the build method will run automatically. Let's write def build self. Let's pass the input shape parameter. Now, let's create layer weights using the add weight method. This method helps you easily add weight to the layer. To be an attribute of instance, let's start with the self keyword. Self w equals self. Let's type add weight. Let's use the shape parameter to get the size of the input. Shape equals, let's set input shape. Pass -1 and then write self.units. Note that weights are initially initialized with random values. Let's use the initializer parameter to determine from which distribution the samples will be taken. Let's write initializer equals, let's give random normal. Let's use the trainable parameter to train the weights with backpropagation. Let's write trainable equals, let's set true. Cool, we created layer weights. Next, let's create the bias attribute. Now let's do the same for bias. Let's write self b equals self. Let's use the add weight method. Let's type add weight. After that, write the shape parameter and give it the units parameter. Let's write shape equals, let's set self.units. Note that bias is initially assigned class values. Let's write initialized equals, let's set zeros. Next, use the trainable parameter to train the bias with backpropagation. Let's write trainable equals, let's set true. Cool, we created layer weights and bias. Let's go ahead and write the call method to do the calculations. Let's write def call, let's set self and give inputs. And then, let's use the return keyword to return the calculated value. Return. Next, multiply the inputs with the weights and add them with the bias. Let's write tf matmul. Let's give inputs and self.w. After that, plus self b. Awesome, we built our custom layer. Let's create a sample data and go through this layer. Let's write x equals tf ones. Let's give 2, 2. Let's create an instance from the linear class. Let's write linear layer equals linear. Let's pass the number of units, let's say 4. Now let's go the data through the layer. Let's write y equals linear layer. Let's set x. Cool, outputs calculated. Let's take a look at these values. Let's write y. Here you can see the layer outputs. Awesome, we created a custom layer. In this video, we've seen how to create a custom layer. You can use this custom layer in any model you want. That's it. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoy it. You can find the link to this notebook in the description below. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon, so you don't miss the latest content about AI and data science. You can also follow us on other social media accounts. See you in the next video. Bye for now.